animals came on this life just to show their feelings and their participation and their friendship to the humans. So when the world was parting in two parts, one side the humans and on the other side the animals, on the last minute when the earth was participating, it was cutting in two, the humans were completely alone. So one cat and one dog, they had a discussion and they say, "Why, I feel sorry," they say, you know, the dog to the cat and the cat to the dog. "Let's jump over to the other side and be good friends with the humans. Because they're nice humans, they're nice people, you know. So maybe they will take good care of us." So they jump over, and so life was finished. And life was continuing, and look what happens now. An old poor man, let's say 78 years old, for the last 20, 25 years. I've been collecting animals from the streets, dead bodies, brutalized animals. So you've seen, just this is just 1% of the rest of this, what I'm doing now. And I destroy my property as well, my house. As you can see, I had a beautiful villa made by hard working. So everything is destroyed, everything. I have no life, I have no future. I don't even have money to exist. I don't even have a social security money as an old man, let's say, of 78 years old. And now I'm staying here with the dogs. People call me, the police call me, "Mr. James, please, a dog is dying, a donkey is dying, a horse is been hidden from a car. Please, can you help us?" So I go every day. I receive phone calls, maybe 10. Before some years, I used to receive 20, 30 phone calls a day, just for the animals. I had an ambulance, Egypt has been destroyed. And now, still I'm doing this. I'm collecting sick dogs, dead bodies from the streets, poison animals.
By pieces of meat with broken glasses. Imagine what happens inside. A scientist who is involved with animals, is impossible, he said, to describe the suffering of an animal where he's dying from this poison. "I cannot find any word," he said. We brought two animals from England. We used to live in a suburb called Calamaria, and they poisoned these two dogs inside our house. I couldn't see animals. And my wife too, killed them on the streets or poisoned on the streets. We couldn't stand this, you understand me? And we decided to start something.
Here I have thousands of pictures. This is a newspaper, a new one. It's the biggest paper on distribution in whole Greece.
Uh-huh. It's a Sunday one,
yes. Three pages for Dimitri Samaras. Three pages. You see that? Mm-hmm. So what? I have hundreds of newspapers and videos, you know. I've been to the television more than 200 times. And here the dog is. You got the picture? You can stick it on yours, you know. Look at here. This is my real life. though I had a good life. Well, you know, when I was young, I left Greece. I was born here. And the reason I came back, because my mother, she was very sick. For that reason, you know, just for sentimental reasons. I'm really very sorry that I came back. I'm deeply hurt. I made a nice family, 3 boys, a nice wife from England. So they went back to England again. They left Greece for good. For good, they'll never come back again. And that's it. I met the best gym in the country, and instead of lifting me up and say, "You are the best fellow, man, Jimmy's. You did something fantastic," because it was not only health club. Sick people used to come in. Sick people, you understand, from hospitals. I used to cure people with my own hands. They destroy me. Some rich people. They destroy my club because of jealousy. There are no laws in this country. I was out of business, so I'm going around and begging for money. Friends, I used to have very good friends, very rich friends. Sometimes I helped them financially because I was rich too. Well, not a millionaire, but I was rich. So they don't even offer me a cup of coffee. I have been forgotten completely, though I know thousands of people, and they know me, of course, because of the health club, which I had 3,500 memberships. 3,500 memberships. Can you imagine? So I'm all alone now, all alone, me and the animals. I suffer from, sometimes I suffer from loneliness, depression. I'm very depressed because I live alone. I have to walk 10 to 12, sometimes 15 hours a day. No help, no assistance, no doctors, nothing. 20 million euros came from Brussels, from Belgium, from the EVG, from the common market, for the stray animals. So I went to the minister in Athens and I say, "Can you help me, please?" Everybody knew me. I gave him my DVDs and everything. I went there officially, and the assistant of the minister of agriculture, "Let me tell you something," and she looked at me on the eyes. "There is no money left." Unbelievable. I was laughing. 20 million euros. Can you imagine? For the animals from the street, they disappear. Thieves, gangsters, grabbers. This is Greece. What I think I learned from the dogs is love, giving love, even to your enemy, appreciation, gratitude. What I'm trying to do and what I'm doing is try to help and protect these poor souls, you know, these souls, these poor things, the unprotected. And they come next to you and they say, they beg you, "Please take me with you. Give me some love. Give me some food. Please don't kill me."
That's what they say. I know. They beg you not to make their life shorter.
So there is nothing I can do. The only thing I can do is just leave this house or sell it and go back to my family and live in England, of course, and live and exist with dignity, you know. If I leave Greece, what's going to happen to these poor creatures, these animals? You know what's going to happen? All of them, they're going to be killed. All of them, they're going to be killed by euthanasia. They're going to put him to sleep, one way or the other. The Greek government, you know.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has won. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. The sight of you leaves me numb. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my